Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Kavanaugh Fieldhouse here at Lynn English High School for boys basketball. This is the starting lineup for the visiting team, the Peabody Tanners. Number 23, Chris Canello. Number 12, Tyler Kellanan. Number 4, Jake Irvin. Number 32, Marcus Barker. And number 2, Jake Gustin. Head coach for Peabody is Thad Broden. And now for the Lynn English Bulldogs. Starting at guard, number 4, freshman Luis Rivera. At forward, freshman number 11, Ademide Badmus. Yes, he is a freshman. At guard, junior number 5, Alonzo Linton. Number 1, senior forward Javaris Hill. And number 2, captain. Number 2, the senior captain, Javonte Edwards. The head coach for the Bulldogs is Antonio Anderson. And two teams huddle up here. Lynn English coming off a classic, fantastic ball game the other night here at Lynn English. They squeaked by classical 63-60 in overtime in a phenomenal ball game. And Peabody comes in looking to knock off the division-leading Bulldogs. Lynn English comes in with a record of 9-1 to get Peabody's record at halftime. But I notice as they announce the starting lineup, this is a senior-dominated team for Peabody. English has got 2 freshmen starting, a junior and 2 seniors. But they have played 10 games in the season, so they're probably, I guess you'd have to call them, as they call them at Lynn English, freshmores by this point, as Javonte easily wins the tap. Alonzo Linton had an unbelievable game the other night, 35 points. He was a monster. Quickly inside to Ademide, puts in an easy 2, and Lynn English is on the board. They're up 2-0. The press, Peabody breaks it. Let's see how English comes out. Looks like they're in there 1-2-2. That's how they played the other night. A long 3. That goes for, that is Chris Canal, Chris Canada. I think that's the name. For 3, Luis Rivera comes right back with a 3. And that 3 rims out. Good position by Peabody. And that'll be off on Javaris Hill. So we're just underway here. 7 minutes to go in the first quarter. It's 5-3 English. All alone from the corner. Misses it. And Badmus almost taps it into the other, Peabody basket. Edwards quickly to Rivera. Brings it up court. Looks like Peabody. And Linton's 3 is off. Rebound to Canada. Number 4, another 3. That goes. And that is Jake Irvine. So Peabody's is up on 2 threes. They're up 6-5. There's already been 3 threes in this game. Inside to Hill. Knocked away nicely. Batted away by Peabody. And English sets up man-to-man. No, a long 3. So it looks like Peabody's going to be throwing up those 3s. Here comes Linton around the back. Easily the basket, but it rims out. Nice drive by Linton. Won't go. 6-5 Peabody. Number 32 takes the basket. Almost gets his own rebound. Hill tries to drive through 2 people. Has the ball stripped away. Right back to Peabody. Number four, Jake Irvine. This is Canada, throws up an air ball there. Hill drives to the basket. Might have taken, nope, got hit on the floor. It looked like he took a step, but I guess he was fouled before the shot on a reach in. That'll be the first foul. And Hill takes a seat, and Calvin Singh comes in. So they probably lose about a foot here, but they pick up a three-point shooter, and Calvin, too short. Singh had, I believe, 3 three-pointers the other night against Classical. He can shoot. And number 12 having a little trouble handling the ball. So far, I think every shot for Peabody's been a three. Until that one, that baseline jumper by Tyler Callanan. And Peabody on top. Linton for three. Short. Front rims it. Gets his own rebound. And he's fouled. Let's see if they say he was in the act of shooting. That's a second team foul on Peabody. Looks like Linton is going to be on the line shooting too. So, for Peabody, it's been a three-point dominated offense for English. Still trying to get on track. Linton scores his first point of the buck of the evening on the, from the free throw line. Brings English within two. The second one is up and rims out. But nice rebound by Rivera as he snuck in. Quickly to Rivera in the corner for three. Ooh, just rims out. Rebound. Quickly up court. It's 2-on-1. Nice pass, but knocked away by Linton to Edwards. And we'll give Javonte credit for the dunk there. It was a gentleman's dunk. Eight apiece. Pass is wild and out of bounds. Inside, all alone, Badmus. They let him set up underneath there. Nothing they can do about that. If they give him position, he's going to score. Quickly, they break the press underneath. Nice play as Kaneda used his body to fend off the defender. And we're all even at 10 here. 3:38 to go, first quarter in the corner. That's Manalese. Just came in replacing Rivera. And Linton, English cold. Miles Manalese in. Irvine, English in man-to-man here. Playing off him here. Irvine for three. No, air ball. That ball go back to English. Didn't draw iron. Head coach Antonio Anderson talking with Calvin Singh at the break in the action here as Javonte Edwards ties his shoe. And here we go, all even at 10. Alonso Linton brings the ball up. Peabody in a 2-3 zone. Singh for three, too strong. And Linton almost steals it away. A kick by Manalese. As English with a three-quarters court press, but so far Peabody has been able to beat it. Peabody inbounding. Nobody coming to the ball, but they're able to break that. This is Jake Gustin with Edwards on him. Stolen away by Edwards. Quickly down court. Ooh, nice defense as just as Javonte His eyes were as big as saucers. He thought he was going to be able to jam that one, and the ball was slapped away nicely. Linton inbounds under the basket. Gets it to Badmus in the corner. Peabody in a 2-3 zone. Sang in the corner. Manalese for three. Can't connect. So far, they've got 1-3. They've missed their last probably five or six attempts here. So the whole team is cold right now. Badmus gets it up top. Tyshawn Anderson, number 32, in. Linton turns down. They got him. Got him on a travel as Linton turned down the three. Took it to the basket. Good move by Linton. When the team is cold, best way to get back on track is to take it to the basket, but took a step on the way. Quickly, right around Singh. As Peabody sets up, a long three by Irvine is good, as that's his second. He's got a big height advantage over Manalese. Back out to Linton. English trails by three, Singh for three. That one goes. Calvin, not timid here about jacking up the threes, and that one went. We're all even. Singh. To get him on a reach-in. Singh on a reach-in. And that's the first team foul on English. Peabody has two. Gio Cordero replacing Badmus. So, Antonio Anderson getting... Irvine right around everybody. Nice block by Cordero as Irvine was all alone. Irvine for three. Somebody's going to have to get on him. That's his third three. Linton around the back. Back to Singh for three. All good. And Peabody on top by three. They've got four threes here in the first quarter. Kaneda looking for another one, but he drives the lane. He gets fouled. Let's see who they get that one on. That's the first one on Cordero. Nice fake. Got him in the air, and that is Gustin with his first bucket. Nice pump fake. All alone for the bucket, and Peabody with a five-point lead, less than a minute to go, and Singh. Cordero with a nice rebound as he got position. Linton still not on the board. Manalese for three. Short. Anderson, nice pass, but blocked. Nice pass, Anderson to Cordero, but blocked. And let's see. We got about 1 second difference on the shot clock here. They can pretty much hold it for the rest of the quarter if they want to, but they like to throw up those threes, especially Irvine. He's got three himself. Stolen away, stolen back. Nice move, won't go. Anderson. Cordero, here comes Linton. Ooh. They got him on a blocking foul as Linton went around the back with 1/10 of a second left on the clock. They're gonna give him two shots on that. I'm surprised. Didn't look like a shooting foul, but they're gonna put him on the line, or he went to the line anyway. Now as Linton tried to outsmart the refs. Manalese throws it up, and no, and Peabody with a surprising 18-13 lead at the end of one here at Lynn English. Okay, we rolling? Okay, here we go. Start of the second quarter, Peabody inbounding at midcourt, leading by five. It's been a three-point shooting display by the Tanners, and English has been ice cold. Sang hit 1-3, and Rivera another. Nice rebound underneath. Clears out, and Linton pulls down the board. Brings it up court quickly. This is Jean-Baptiste. Nice pass, but Javaris Hill couldn't hold it. So number 13, Mason Jean-Baptiste. Edwards, nice defense as Javante went to the basket. Rebound to Peabody, and they slow it down. All alone in the corner, but misses it. That's Kaneda, and Hill quickly up to Linton. Good defense by Peabody, gets it to Edwards. Knocked away as Javante a little out of control that time. Ball knocked away by Peabody. Good pass inside. Linton, as Hill cuts to the basket, they didn't see him. Linton holds the ball. Looking to try to get that ball inside. The threes are not falling for English right now. Waiting for, as Badmus moves. Nice move. Didn't draw iron. 30-second clock as Badmus cut the lane, but his little hook shot didn't draw iron. Air ball and shot clock violation. Well, as Edwards slapped that ball away, but it hit the end line, and it'll be Peabody ball. So for English, it's Linton, Badmus, Edwards, Hill, and head coach Thad Broughton calls timeout as it looked like they might get inbounds violation, and Broughton calls a timeout. So far, it's been Peabody from the outside. They've got four threes, three of them by Jake Irvine, another by Chris Kaneda. And English has been throwing them up too, but they haven't been falling. And Badmus has two nice moves on the inside, but other than that, English has pretty much been, I don't know if I'll say sleepwalking, but their offense has not come alive yet. They definitely have the height and quickness on Peabody, but they haven't been able to put it together yet. As the Bulldogs come back out on the court, number five, Alonzo Linton, with a superhuman performance on Wednesday night in that overtime thriller, scoring 35 points to lead English to the victory. As Peabody inbound, 6:44 to go here in the first half. Tanners on top, 18-13. Good defense, finally, they're able to inbound. Stolen away nicely, and count that by Javante Edwards, and he's fouled. Stole the ball away under the basket, scored. Let's see if he can convert the three here. That's the fourth team foul. The second one on Marcus Barker. Edwards sets. Converts the conventional three-point play to bring English within two. And now, a reach in, and that's been the bugaboo for Edwards, picking up those reach-in fouls as English pressing full court now. I want to see, so far they've been pressing, but they picked up the intensity here. The problem with that is Edwards is prone to picking up fouls. Almost throws it away. Irvine's in the corner, back out. English with that pressing. Ooh. Edwards, Linton. Let's see what they call here. They're going to call a foul, looks like. Or was that a jump ball? Let's see what they call it. Looked like they might have got a foul. Yeah, that foul is on Kinnaid, I believe. Yep. Foul on Kinnaid. English kind of lucky on that possession. It looked like they might have gotten a hill on a reach in. So English looking to tie this game up. Bad miss. Misses everything, and there's Edwards. Nice pass. Bad miss to Edwards. We're all even. English has picked up the intensity. I believe that's what head coach Antonio Anderson was talking about. They got to take it to Peabody, and they've been doing that. Edwards just has to be careful about those reach-in fouls. Ooh, almost thrown away. We got a nice defense by Badmus as they trapped, and Kinnaida just threw the ball away. And English, that ratcheting up the intensity, and it's working. All even at 18. Peabody staying in that 2-3 zone. English looking to ball, get the ball in inside. Linton right to the basket. Ooh, rims out. Linton again follows his own shot. Nice play by Alonzo Linton. First bucket of the game. And English trapping causes that turnover. Broden talking with the ref as the Bulldogs have suddenly woken up. And Peabody so far has not been able to handle the intensity. Linton inbounds Hill all alone, but couldn't score. Hill on the follow-up. So that's the strategy. Get it to the big man inside. And another turnover as Peabody. A little mini self-destruction here. It's only 4 points. And a technical on the head coach here as must have said something. That was quick. Jean Baptiste on the line, shooting the tech. It's the first. This is the second. So, Peabody in foul trouble here with 5:20 to go. Next one will put English in the 1-1. Hill inbounds at midcourt. English was only three. Linton to Hill in the corner. Nice pass to Linton, but they got Linton a pretty pass. Hill to a cutting Linton, but they got him on the, said he took an extra step. It's all right, English got the benefit of a couple of calls. They might have lost that one, but, and here comes Peabody. Number one in there, pass a little behind him. Long three by Irvine. Kid can shoot the ball. Number one, Avian Hernandez. English on top by two. Hill drives the lane. Pretty little runner by Javaris Hill. Took the Euro step. English pressing. Full court. Trap. Oh, almost stolen away. Nice pass down court. Blocked from behind by Badmus. They might have got it. Hill. Pretty blocked by Ademidi Badmus from behind. Let's see who that, I believe that was on Hill. Let's see who they get it on. Or was it Edwards? Yeah, on Hill. First on Hill. Rivera back in. Nice move. Couldn't convert, though. Nice move to the back by Kinnaida. Lou Rivera back in. Quickly to Linton. Back out. Rivera for three. Nope. Rebound. Edwards. Javonte Edwards. and Calvin and Javaris Hill are dominating under the basket. Nats Hernandez throws it away. 27-21. Let's see who this is. Number 14. I don't have him. Badmus takes a seat on the bench. This is Hill. To Rivera. Linton for three. No, as nobody, they can't buy a bucket, but they're dominating inside, and they have a six-point lead in spite of their cold shooting touch. Nice move by Gustin. Won't go, though. Hill. He gets hacked, and that should put Javaris Hill on the line, shooting 1-1. That's their seventh, or eighth, actually. Javaris shooting 1-1, and I believe number 14 is Jordan Todd. Hill for the first one, converts. So the Bulldogs with only 14 fouls with 3:37 to go in the half. And Peabody has put English in the 1-1. Second one sneaks in. English with their biggest lead of the game. That's the second one on Hill. So Hill picks up two quick fouls here. English up by eight, their biggest lead, as nice play as they had in the outlet pass, but English gets back. Good position by, Tyler Callanan, as he muscled his way in there. He beat everybody on the outlet, but English got back and then he muscled his way in for the basket. This is Rivera, way long, but Hill with the rebound, pretty. Went under the basket in his little wraparound. They got no answers for Hill and Edwards underneath. Peabody quickly back. Kaneda for three. Nope. Here, two, three on one here. Linton to Hill for two. Broden calls timeout. And with 2:53 in the second quarter here, English is opened up a 10-point lead. It's 33-23. So, Javaris Hill has exploded for 10 points here in the second quarter, and English has outscored Peabody 20-5 to start this out. Start out the second quarter. Ooh, almost blocked. Nice follow-up. But getting over the back foul. I believe that's on Todd, and Peabody will be shooting two. Foul on Rivera. Luis Rivera picks up his first. This will be Callanan or Callahan, maybe. Makes the first. Second one is too strong. Stolen away by Hernandez. Tyshawn Anderson back in. Linton with the steal. And a jam by Alonzo Linton as he floated through the air and jammed that one home. Nice highlight for English. Trapping in the backcourt, but they break the trap. 32. Nice move. And that's Callahan took it nicely to the basket. Hill, all Javaris Hill as he followed his own miss and converted. 2 minutes to go. 2-on-1 break for Peabody. Nice fake as he gets Todd in the air, and that's Callahan. He'd be on the line shooting too. He got Todd in the air. It's Todd's first foul. Puts English. Guess they have English with seven now. So both teams will be shooting one-on-one for the last 2 minutes of the half. Callahan makes a pair. Edwards back in, Hill out. Todd with a little baseline. Nice baseline jump shot. Smooth shot there. First bucket of the game. They break the press. And the three goes. That's Marcus Barker. His first bucket is a three. Peabody hanging in there. Almost stolen by Hernandez. Oh, nice pass as Rivera threw a bullet to Tyshawn Anderson. He's used to breaking up the passes, not catching them. Anderson out, bad miss in, as Antonio Anderson getting a lot of players in, some in and out. Manalese in for Anderson. Almost took a step, no call. Let's see, was that ball hit? I guess so. 108 to go. Say it was off English. English in that man-to-man. Nice cut. Blocked by Badmus. Nice cut by Callahan. Blocked by Badmus. Manalese, good D. Couldn't put up a three. Todd, too long. See what we call. I believe they're going to get Badmus on that. If they do, they'll be shooting. Yep. So Badmus picks up his first, but puts Peabody on the line, and Callahan has really come alive here. He's got seven here in the quarter. Looking to add to that. He's kept Peabody in the game. Makes the first. Peabody hanging tough. Trail by seven. Next one won't go. Badmus with the rebound. Litton with a quiet night here outside of that majestic dunk. Manalese may have gotten bailed out on that one. That pass didn't have much on it, but Badmus gets fouled. Be on the line, shooting one and one. That foul on Irvine, his second. So lots of Tanners with two fouls here. Badmus shooting one and one. First misses. That's leaving points on the board here. Peabody looking to get within four or five here. Callahan's been their offense. Nice play by Irvine. Ooh, Callahan couldn't hit the short little jumper. Linton, shot clock off. Linton back to Manalese for three. Ooh, just missed. They're going to have Edwards over the back as Javonte Edwards went over the back. That'll be his second foul as Edwards picks up his second, and English, which only had 14 fouls a little over maybe 2 minutes ago, has quickly caught up with Peabody. They both have 19 fouls now. And that puts Peabody misses. But Hernandez, Hill goes to the floor. But I believe he was on the baseline. So Shot clock off. Peabody inbounding. Trail by 7. Look to get a little closer here. Oh, wow. English got lucky on that play as Barker was all alone. This is Irvine. No good. As nice play by Litton as Irvine spun and really couldn't get much of a shot off. Barker broke all alone to the basket. Pass was led him a little too much, and he couldn't convert, or Peabody would only trail by 5. So at the end of one half here at Lynn English, it's the Bulldogs 39 and Peabody 32. So the teams are getting a little bit of last-minute instruction before we start the second half. In the second quarter, Lynn English, they were down by 5 coming into the second quarter, but they outscored Peabody 26-14 to take a 7-point lead heading here into the second half. It's 39-32, Lynn English on top. In that second quarter, Javaris Hill and Javonte Edwards were unstoppable underneath. Hill had 12 points in the quarter, and Edwards had 7. So they accounted for 19 of the 26 points. English has been very cold from the outside here. They've shooting percentage can't be much, probably under 20. But they've been dominant underneath, and their press began to have an impact in the second quarter. So Peabody stays in that 2-3, and Linton, English right away in that trapping press. Peabody breaks it. Nice pass. They break it, and that's Barker to Kaneda cutting the lane. Nice play, and he's fouled. Let's see who they get that one on. As Linton opens up the second half with a bucket, it's only his 7th point of the game. That'll be the second one on Badmus. And this is Chris Kaneda. It's the first one. So Badmus with 2. This is the second. What do we got here? That's a lane violation. He missed it. So we 4 the Bulldogs. Linton with the ball. Hill in the backcourt with him. Edwards at the top of the key. Linton all alone, a little too strong. This is Calvin Sang in. So it's Sang, Linton, Hill, Badmus, and Edwards. Well, they got a moving pick here, a block on Gustin. I believe that's his 4th. Jake Gustin picking up a block. And they're going to have to... Probably going to have to replace him. This is Badmus to Sang in the corner. Barely drew iron. And Edwards is fouled. Oh, no. Look, I thought they were signaling the other way as Edwards. Here we go again. Javonte picking up those fouls, and he's on the bench again. He played a significant role in the classic game, but he was on the bench most of the game, but he was a key player in the last few minutes of the game, but spent most of the time on the bench. So Edwards with 3, Badmus with 2, and Peabody hanging around. Hill, nice pick. Ooh, Edwards, Tyshawn Edwards comes in replacing Javonte. Linton right to the basket, pretty much untouched, and then he was fouled right as he tried to lay that ball off the glass. That's the 3rd foul here on Barker. So Peabody, 2 play. So they got Barker with 3, Gustin with 4. Both teams with 2 team fouls, and Linton on the line shooting 2. First one good. Thad Broughton, head coach for Peabody, is going. No, Linton's second one won't go, but Hill with the rebound. Sang just can't find the range, but Hill with the rebound couldn't put in a little bunny, and English continues to be cold. This game should be no contest at this point. Anderson plays that tight defense, but Irvine goes right around him, and they'll get the foul on Tyshawn Anderson. Irvine on the line shooting two. All his points up. He's got four threes for 12. That one rattles in. His first points. Other than threes. Irvine. Leading scorer for Peabody. Second one rattles in. Neither of them were pretty, but they count. Manalese in. Hill out. So, English going with the smaller lineup here as the two big men, Hill and Edwards, on the bench. Badmus still in. Manalese. They just can't. Nobody. It's like that shooting. That ice cold shooting is contagious as nobody can hit for English. Kaneda to Irvine, looking to get free. Jump shot, count it as he can shoot. He's keeping Peabody in this with 16 points. 5:35 to go, and Peabody trails by five. This is Anderson. And Antonio Anderson letting him have it. He wasn't happy with that. Not sure if he wanted Tyshawn to shoot that, but called a quick timeout. And he's over there chewing his players out right now. They're trying to figure out. Right now they're so cold that their only offense is coming from around the basket. And a lot of those threes, when you shoot from that distance, those rebounds come far away from the rim, and what they really need is to just put the ball up on the, shoot them, put them up on the rim, and let the players go and follow up and score, because Peabody can't defend them on the backboards. But the threes just aren't falling, and they're caroming far from the basket, and Peabody only down by five. They do have two players in foul trouble. Not their big scores, though. That Gustin and Barker, two starters, though. English inbounds. This is Linton. Sang, Manalese. Okay. Finally, as Miles hits from three. That's only the third three. First two came early in the first quarter. They probably missed a good 10 or 12 in a row. As Sang pounding Gustin in the backcourt. They break it. Anderson with a nice defense on the steal. He pulls it up. Almost gets called for the travel. Nothing doing as Tyshawn pulls it back out. Linton hasn't really gotten untracked. Anderson sets a pick. This is Sang for three. Nope. Sang out, and this is Jordan Todd in. Almost everyone has seen some action here. I don't think Sam Adewale hasn't been in yet. Number 10 for English, but Coach Anderson's been shuttling the players in and out. This is Linton. This is Todd. And Jordan Todd connects. So, That 5-point lead is now 11. Peabody inbounds. 4:20 to go. Kaneda for three. Nice touch. And they're trading threes. Linton with a runner. Woo! A runner from about 15 feet. Tough shot by Alonzo Linton. Made it look easy. That is not an easy shot. English pressing. As Irvine launched that over Anderson, hit the back iron, Linton. Stolen away by Peabody. Nice pass. Barker to Kaneda, very nice pass. And English calls timeout as every time English looks like, I guess not. I thought that they had called timeout, but no. Peabody hanging in. .325 to go in the third quarter. Linton with the Euro step. And Alonzo Linton looks like he's taken matters into his own hands now. Euro step. And a power move to the basket after that pretty running. Ooh, Callahan all alone. Got Badmus in the air, but it's like he may have taken steps as Callahan was all alone. He heard the footsteps from behind him and Badmus came in. Thought he might have gotten called for the foul, but Callahan took steps before that. Badmus intimidating. Linton. Badmus with the rebound. Manolese. As they set up. Back out to Linton. Anderson. This is Todd. Too strong. Manolese for the rebound. Shot won't go. And they're going to get Tyshawn Anderson on a reach in. English with 14 fouls and Peabody with only two this half. Full court press. Irvine able to bring it in with Linton all over him. Callahan cuts the basket, couldn't handle it. Linton back to Todd for three. Rebound back out to Manolese for three. Rims out. Manolese with his own rebound. Another three. That time it counts. Miles with two threes. That time missed the first. Got the long rebound. Nothing but net on the second. Barker almost throws it away. Irvine. English extends the lead to 13. Manolese again, too short. Let's see what they get here. They might have gotten Badmus. Let's see what they get here. Yep, they got Badmus over the back, and that's for Ademity. That's his third, as Peabody calls the timeout here. So, with 1:36 left in the third quarter, it's Lynn English 55 and Peabody 42. The players step back out onto the court here for Lynn English. Alonzo Linton has stepped up here in the third quarter with 7 points. Javaris Hill and Javonte Edwards carried the team in the second quarter. This quarter, it's been Linton, along with two threes from Manolese and a three for Todd for their points. Peabody inbounding. As the clock starts ticking down, 1:32 to go in the third quarter. Gio Cordero stolen away by Manolese. Good hustle by Miles. Goes to the court. And Linton gets called for the steps. Gio Cordero in for Badmus, who picked up his third personal just before the timeout. I don't want him picking up his fourth here at the end of the third quarter. Manalese, they're trapping, but Peabody able to beat it, and nice cut to the basket for Kaneda for two. Nice give and go. Linton goes to the basket. Manalese. Edwards pulls, rips the ball away. Todd takes it right to the basket. Beautiful rebound by Tyshawn Anderson. Ripped the ball away, and Todd with a nice driving. He drove the lane and scored. A little floater. Big bucket for English. 30 seconds to go. 15 on the shot clock. English will get the ball one more time this quarter. Probably one more time. Nice cut by Irvine. Pretty cut as Peabody. That backdoor cut by Jake Irvine, and he's fouled on the play. That's on Cordero. That's his second. And that'll put Irvine on the line. Number 10 for English makes his first appearance. I don't have him on the roster. I'm not sure who that is, but this is Irvine shooting, trying to complete the three-point play, and he does. Seconds left, shot clock off. Isolation for Linton. Anderson, number 10 from the corner, hits a big three. And Peabody throws it up and it gets stuck in the netting. Let's see if our camera person can get a shot of the ball up there in the netting. See it up there? Hey. All right. And they're going to have to, here it comes, as it finally drops down. As that ball was shot by Peabody, hit the netting, and now they're bringing it down. I'm not sure why. Ball's not in it anymore. The ball stayed up there for about 15 seconds and then dropped out. Now they're bringing the net back up. That's used for gym classes here to separate into basically two separate courts here. So we got one quarter to go here, and that three will give English a 13-point lead. It's 60-47 as Peabody's ready to go and English still in the huddle. Big three-point bucket there. And they've been few and far between, although that quarter, English actually had four. Shooting percentages are way down, but here we go. Starting the fourth quarter. This is Callahan with the ball. Irvine, tough shot, and he's fouled. He'll be shooting two. Strong player, number four for Peabody. He's got four threes. Got 19 points unofficially. On the line shooting two. First one, too short. Second one is good. Almost stolen away by Peabody. This is Linton handling the ball. Another three, that time by Todd. It's his second. Number 10 is Matt Montanario. Almost stolen away by English. This is the largest lead of the game, 15, but Peabody's still hanging in. Irvine with Montanario all over him. Gets it inside. Callahan. The short jumper. So, going with a whole different lineup here. They've got, as they trap Linton, he's able to get away with it. Montanario back out. So the big man is the point guard up top. This is, nice one-handed grab by Manalese. Ooh, just rims out. Good. Nice play by Montanario. Couldn't keep it alive, though. And Peabody, Irvine, Montanario playing Manalese to Anderson. Beautiful pass back to Montanario. Good hustle there. Beautiful play. Anderson to Montanario. Stolen away by Montanario. Ahead to Anderson. Dishes back to Montanario for two. This is Barker on the line shooting two. Oh, one on one. English with eight fouls now. Quickly, Linton to the top of the key and a pretty jump shot for Alonzo Linton. And English pulling away now with 6 minutes to go. They're up by 17. And we got a 3-on-2 break. Linton by himself to Montanario for two. And suddenly, the player that I couldn't identify is supplying a lot of offense here. Ooh, nice lay-in by Hernandez, his first bucket of the game. But Peabody can't afford to trade baskets here as they try trapping Linton. Ball stays with English. So an unusual lineup here, but it's working for the Bulldogs with big man Alonzo Linton handling the ball up top. Tyshawn Anderson in there for defense, and then Todd, Montanario, and Manalese shooting threes. Manalese, oof. As Miles fakes a three, goes baseline, and he got hit in the air. Be on the line shooting two. That's the fourth on Barker. Four on Barker, four on Gustin, but they've been able to stay in the game here. Nobody fouled out yet. Manalese shooting two. Hits the first. It's a pair. English keeping the pressure on. 5:15 to go. This is my... believe they got that on Anderson, but let's see. Yep. It's the second on Tyshawn, but the ninth on the team. So 1-1, next foul, double bonus, and we still got 5:09 to play. Makes the first, Kaneda. Hernandez in, Callahan out. Second one won't go. Linton and Anderson. Linton pulls it away from Anderson. Good defense there as he was looking to get it to Todd in the corner, and Gustin came flying down to knock it out of bounds. Good hustle by Jake Gustin. Linton will inbound under the English basket. Anderson back out. Back to Linton. English in no hurry. 15 seconds on the clock. Manalese for three. Won't go. Smiles' arms are going to be tired tomorrow. He's jacked up quite a few threes tonight. This is Irvine. Nice fake. Passes back out. Long three. Won't go. Anderson with the rebound. Strong rebound. Linton. Todd for three. Ooh, rims out. Tyshawn Anderson. Nice pass. Montanario. Beautiful dish by Linton to Montanario. Wouldn't go. Gustin. Good defense. But they're going to get Montanario on the foul. Got a piece of him. Beyond the Light shooting two. Javonte Edwards, who has spent this whole quarter on the bench with those fouls, ready to head back in here, replacing Anderson. Did some strong work on the boards. Plays his usual tough defense. Oh, no good. Montanario with the rebound. So Edwards in for Anderson. Linton, nice move. Goes around the defender and tosses it in. And English, looks like they probably have this game. They're up by 19. Long three won't go. Linton, English in no hurry. Anderson sets a pick. Linton. And Linton can't convert. Off on Linton. Let's see who we got. We got a timeout here by English. So with 3:30 to go in the game, it's the Bulldogs on top, 73-54. Peabody inbounding. 3:30 to go. English still pressing. Manalese and Todd. Miles with the steal. Oh, he didn't look up. Finally did. Got Edwards at the last second. As I thought he was going to miss him. Looking down, but got the ball to Javonte for his first bucket of the second half. English finally goes on top by 21. Irvine can't convert. And Linton and Irvine, two strong ball players. And the possession arrow goes to English. Peabody still playing hard. Montanario took steps. As he looked up and saw a defender and took a quick jog step and got called for it. This is Irvine, though. Off. Edwards couldn't corral that one. Callahan can't get it. Edwards pulls the board down over to Linton. And Alonzo slowly brings the ball past midcourt. Kicks it to the corner. Montanario won't go. Manolese, nice board by Miles. Dishes to Montanario. Beautiful play by Miles Manolese. Peabody, count it. As Kaneda went, nice drive to the basket. Now they're playing for their stats now. But I unofficially here. As Sam Adewale and Gio Cordero come in replacing Linton and Edwards. Sam makes his first appearance. I believe that's everybody off the bench. And Kaneda converts the three-point play. Manolese to Cordero. He can hit around the back, stolen away. As Cordero with the around the back pass. Cordero. Nice bounce pass to Adewale, but smacked away. And unofficially, I have Matt Montanario with 3, 6, 8, 10, 12 points. And Jordan Todd with 13. Those are unofficial, but those are two play right there. That's, I believe that's close to 25 points. Two players that didn't even play in the game on Wednesday. That's Todd just missing on the three. And Manolese stolen away. And Montanario again. He's on fire. Can't be stopped. English on top. 79-59. Reach in by Adewale. That puts Peabody on the line shooting two. It's the first. Manolese all alone. Oof. He heard the footsteps and his shot was a little too strong, but he comes racing back on defense. Miles playing hard both ways. Cordero with some good hustle. Don't tell these players English is on top by 19. They're playing for playing time. Peabody. And that foul on Peabody, Gio Cordero. Adewale comes back to the ball. Montanario pulls it back out to Cordero. Manolese, only a freshman, getting some instruction from Anderson. Coach Anderson to Cordero. Puts up a three. Nope. Too strong. Less than a minute to go. Oh. Quick hands by Montanario, tries to slam it, steals it again to Manolese for two. These two players, Manolese and Montanario, showing the coach something here, especially Montanario. Pulls the ball out and back out to Manolese. They're going to let the clock run out, and English is going to walk off with a 21-point lead, but Peabody played tough the entire game. They never gave up, and the clock ticks down one. And it's English, the handshake. English on top, 81-60, as they pull away in the fourth quarter to take this game easily. And the big story in this game was the play of little guys off the bench. In particular, Matt Montanario, who midway through the third quarter, I was still calling him the number 10, and I didn't even know his name, and I was able to get it from one of the fans here. He put on a show here, and I believe he ends up unofficially with 14 points, including a near dunk in the last 30 seconds. Miles Manalese, another huge performance. He had 10, and Jordan Todd chipped in with 13. So those three players accounted for about a third of their offense. The up front, we had big game from Javaris Hill, who had all 12 of his points in the second quarter, and Alonzo Linton, who came through with unofficially 16, but a majority of them here in the second half when they really needed them. So this game was surprising in many ways. English dominating on the boards. They were not hitting from outside, a low percentage, shooting percentage, but they may have found some players here as they head into the rest of this season. So that'll do it, the final score here. Lynn English extends their lead to 10-1 with an 81-60 win over Peabody. So for my camera people, Annika Euland and Juan Lopez, this is Ken Vorspan saying we hope you enjoyed it. See you next time.